And now on to our dinosaur of the day, Hesperonychus, which was a request from Dinosaur 4602. So thanks. Hesperonychus was a Dromaeosaurid that lived in the Late Cretaceous in what is now Alberta, Canada, was found in the Dinosaur Park Formation, and it was a small bipedal carnivore, estimated to be under 3 feet or 1 meters long and weigh about 4 pounds or 1.9 kilograms.
That is small.
Mm-hmm. It's part of Microraptorinae, which was thought to be only in the early Cretaceous in Asia until they found Hesperonychus.
Now it makes sense why it's so small.
Yeah. And until Hesperonychus was found, Microraptor was the youngest known one, but Hesperonychus lived about 45 million years later. And like Garrett said, Microraptorinae, known for their smallness, Microraptorines, they're small, they can potentially fly or glide, though Hesperonychus probably did not have four wings or glide like Microraptor, and may have been similar to Sinornithosaurus because they are similar in size. Before Hesperonychus, small carnivorous dinosaurs hadn't really been found in North America, and that was strange because in modern ecosystems with endothermic mammals, there are more smaller species than larger ones. The authors described in the paper about it that it weighed about half as much as a pet cat.
I guess 4 pounds, yeah.
Yeah. And Nick Longridge said that it was about half the size of Velociraptor, though it looked kind of like Velociraptor.
Yeah, they're both Dromaeosaurids.
Mm-hmm. Hesperonychus had sharp claws and teeth, and it had a large sickle-shaped claw on its second toe. It probably hunted and ate insects and mammals, amphibians, maybe baby dinosaurs, whatever was small enough for it to eat. It may have spent a lot of time searching for food close to the ground in marshes and forests, too. The type and only species is Hesperonychus elizabethae, and the genus name means western claw. The species name is in honor of Dr. Elizabeth Betsy Nichols, who found the holotype. And Nichols was curator of marine reptiles at the Royal Tyrol Museum, but she passed away in 2004. The holotype of Hesperonychus is one partial pelvic girdle, which is part of the University of Alberta Laboratory for Vertebrate Paleontology Edmonton collections. Dr. Elizabeth Nichols collected the holotype back in 1982, and then Longridge and Curry found the holotype in a drawer in 2007. They found the claws first, and they thought it was a juvenile, and then they found the pelvis with the fused hip bones and confirmed it was an adult.
Cool.
Makes sense, because you see the claws and you think, oh, so small.
Yeah.
So it was described in 2009 by Nick Longridge and Phil Curry. There's a few small toe bones, including the sickle claws, that have been tentatively referred to Hesperonychus. That's also part of the Royal Tyrol's collections. Many fragments and claws of at least 10 individuals have been found that may be Hesperonychus, and that could mean that it was common in the area where it was found. Longridge and Curry said that the fact that it took 100 years after discovering Dinosaur Park Formation to describe and name the small Hesperonychus shows the preservational and collecting biases that shape how we see dinosaurs.
It's like we were talking about earlier with the Abelisaurids.
Exactly. Longridge said that he thinks there are lots more fossils of small carnivorous dinosaurs, especially since there are more small predators than large ones today. He said, quote, "My gut says that when we take a good close look at the fossil record, we'll start to see this kind of animal in a lot of different places." He was quoted in many articles saying that. The next smallest carnivore in the area was Eodelphus, which was a mammal that weighed 21 ounces or 600 grams.
So about half again.
Yeah.
This small one.
Yeah. There's some small animals there. Longridge and Curry think either competition from dinosaurs kept most mammals small, or competition from mammals made most dinosaurs larger, or maybe it's a combination of both.
That's an interesting idea to say that the competition from mammals kept dinosaurs large.
Yeah.
We always talk about it the other way, like dinosaurs were filling all the large niches, so mammals had to stay small until they went extinct.
Yeah.
But looking at it the other way, where it's like the mammals are always small and occupying all these niches where you have to be tiny, so the dinosaurs couldn't shrink tiny enough.
Right. And then the mammals won in the end.
So. Yeah. So we might have been the ones that were smarter all along. Occupying that nice small niche is where you want to be. Right, Sabrina?
Hey. Anyway, so dinosaurs that were smaller than Hesperonychus then might have competed for food and resources with mammals. But dinosaurs that were Hesperonychus' size would have been big enough to eat the largest mammals around.
Yeah, for sure.
Other dinosaurs that lived in the same time and place included Tyrannosaurids, Diplodocus, and Gorgosaurus, and also Dromaeosaurus, and Sinornithosaurus. For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino or click the link on the left.